Welcome, Bout Betters. I'm not going to do a betting recap. Hopefully you were able to cash in on the 5-pick parlay at plus 1265 that I put out for everybody. Hopefully you're able to cash in on a Galvapova finish, as well as that bout not going the distance prop. In all, I placed way too many junk prop bets that took away my profit. The danger of focusing and knowing about MMA and gambling in it is that your ego keeps your money going in the wrong way. And by that, I mean I placed way too many bets. Yes, I was very close on a couple of my other degenerate parlays, as well as even in the prop bets and the people I was trying to get finishes or a particular submission, for example, in Mateos Pereira. But when you're searching for those, even if it's lunch money, it's going to eat away at some of your big profits. So that's a big mistake I'm still doing. I need to retract. I need to limit my scope, not my scope of bets, but the range of bets that I do, and get some kind of money management at the casino going, because it's just going the wrong way. I'm picking really well. I understand what I'm doing here, but the money is going the wrong way, and I could see it, and I know it, and I'm letting you guys know that so that you are aware that, hey, just because you're winning, and if you're not keeping track of what you're doing and how you're doing it, and even if you're somewhat successful, doesn't mean that you can't be better at it. I should be doing better at this gambling game, and I'm not. I'm doing really good at my prediction game. I understand what's going on, but I'm not managing my bets well. I'm not managing my money well, nor doing this in a way that could sustain me profitably for any long term. So, edutainment purposes only, buyer beware. Let's go to this next event, Aspen Ladd versus Norma Dumont. Well, guess what? Another striker versus grappler amount. About Dumont is a good counter striker with strong kicks and blows. She's really slow with her striking defense, but she brings heavy shots and kicks. And even though they don't do she doesn't knock people out, they do a ton of damage when she does hit somebody. I watched that bout with Ashley Evans Smith, and there wasn't really Smith did not test Dumont's wrestling. In fact, Evans Smith was controlled by Norma Dumont. She is physically strong. She has good counter wrestling and good jiu-jitsu. I'm impressed with Dumont's technique, patience, and movement. She is strong in the clinch and has good octagon awareness. Aspen Ladd may have been wise to have waited for Macy Chazon, because this fight is likely to stay on the feet, where Norma Dumont has absorbed less strikes and has a better overall striking defense at 67%. Just as in last week with Marina Rodriguez, Norma has 100% takedown defense against Aspen Ladd's 75% takedown accuracy. But even if Ladd does get this to the ground, Dumont can counter wrestle. She's got a good get-up game. She might be able to reverse this and possibly even submit Ladd. We haven't seen much of her jiu-jitsu. She comes from more of a Sandow background, which is more of a striking and throwing grappling background, not really a submission wrestling or a submission type of martial art, but still, I think it's possible there. Yes, Ladd is more active with 5.2 strikes landed per minute, but her striking accuracy is only 55%. Norma Dumont is also hittable. All her opponents were able to tag off on her, but not really stun her. Aspen Ladd's experience is going to serve her well here, as she has the puzzle to solve. Give me Dumont here on the money line. I don't think that Ladd is as dangerous as Megan Anderson. I'm not wanting to do the MMA math here. When Dumont appeared got knocked out, she was a plus 240 dog, and she came in and attacked Megan Anderson. She made that a really dirty fight at the start. She made some rookie mistakes. She gassed, and we saw that adrenaline dump. Ladd won't have that range advantage. Norma Dumont is not going to be at any sort of disadvantage on the feet, nor on the ground, I think, here. FanDuel has all of Dumont at plus 125, and the over-under being set at minus 250, I'm sorry. So Vegas anticipates a decision and Ladd winning that decision. Yes, Ladd is super tough, but I'm going to be probably chase the not to go distance prop, as well as Dumont by finish. These are some of those props, again, that I'm mentioning that I chase and then I lose. But what I'm going to do this time is I'm not going to filter them throughout all my particular favorites. All the people that I might think, I'm going to tell you, like Marquez, for example. I think Julian Marquez should finish. Am I going to chase him by the finish? We're going to see. But these are the problems that I have in gambling when I start to study, start learning about these bouts. they convince you in your ego that you know what you're doing and you're comfortable doing the prop bets and these parlays. And next thing you know, you may have won a lot of tickets. You've done great, but you're breaking even, making a little money, or at the end of the evening, because you spent your time, money, and food and drinks and everything, you're actually losing money. So be cautious out there. Like and subscribe. Thanks very much. Hit the like, subscribe button, notification button. Thank you.